came about. It's only a one race deal. So how are you balancing this and running the Xfinity Series race for the first time here?
Yeah, absolutely. This just came about like last Friday. We're just getting some good lap times here in this Mobile One Orca Cooler Toyota Tundra. Hopefully it pays off a little bit for my Monster Energy Supra tomorrow in the Xfinity race. But we're going to go out there and see what we got.
So just have a little bit of fun.
Yeah, got a few Monster Energies and we're going to go qualify and sit on the pole.
He's excited about it, Alan.
Jamie, I am with his young teammate, Rafael Lazar. The first time he walked into this speedway was yesterday. What has it been like this last few hours for you?
Well, it's a dream come true, you know. We sacrificed a lot the past few years to get to this point, and we were always thinking about Daytona, and it's a dream come true. I'm really, really excited. I just can't thank everyone at Cavish Motorsport for this awesome JBL Toyota Tundra. They brought me, it made my job way easier.
I saw Kyle giving some advice, your crew chief as well. What are they telling you about qualifying here?
Told me to try to hold it wide open.
That's the best thing for a racer to do, guys. Nice and easy.
Yeah, keeps it simple, right?
Yeah, I like a plan that you feel like you can execute.
Play Greenfield, 11th. Play ran 12th here a year ago, season best finish. And I like, as you said in Larry McReynolds' statement, just got to get in it. If you're in it, you can win it. You can
give yourself that chance.
Here's Norm Benning. 12 have qualified, and 39 looking to make the show. There were 32 spots available.
Just ask Spencer Boyd about getting in it and having a chance to win it. He not only had a chance, he went to victory lane at Talladega, our last super speedway race.
Norm Benning takes the checkers, and 13th of the 13 to go. Jinjo Cobb is on track now in the 10 truck. As you see Benning's time and speed. Here's a good look at the Chevrolet of Jinjo Cobb.
See if she's got the speed to beat some of these guys.
Her career best finish came here at Daytona. Sixth place back in 2011. And it's interesting as you look at the roster of drivers and you go down the list of so many have their career best finish at a place like Daytona. It is the equalizer. And for so many, they mark this one on the calendar as their shot here in Talladega.
It's just an opportunity for a team that doesn't have the best equipment. If your team doesn't have the money to engineer these trucks out to the nth degree, the wind, the air makes up for a lot of the deficit that the truck has built into it.